I don't believe it. It happened again.
What happened again?
The DVR. It didn't tape the football game I wanted to watch. Wisconsin versus Minnesota.
Oh.
What did I do wrong?
I don't know, dear.
I mean, I could fly around the world in one night, but I can't work a DVR? What is wrong with me?
I don't know, dear. Hey, they'll be here at 6.
Ah, in-laws. They come every year on Christmas night. I finish my rounds, I start to unwind, and then the door bursts open and the kids rush in, and they start dancing with the elves. And the elves, well, you know, they get into the eggnog, start riding the reindeer. Oh, now don't get me wrong, I love Christmas. It's just, well, I had $50 out of Wisconsin. Ah, what am I complaining about? It's Christmas. Let's read a Christmas story. But first, I'm going to turn off my cell phone. It's pretty irritating when one of these things goes off in the middle of a story. You guys know I'm also going to unwrap some candies now, too. Okay. All right, well, our story begins once upon a time in a little village here in the North Pole called Christmastown. Now, this town is unique for two reasons. One, there's no Starbucks. And two, everyone who lives here is an elf. Christmas elves enjoy themselves by donning gay apparel or by singing songs in Santa's shop. Of course, I always like it when they sing a Christmas carol. I like it even better when they stop.
Santa!
Night and day, they dance and play. They never sleep much either. Would some peace and quiet be a crime? Of course, I love each one of them, but Santa needs a breather because they're just so happy all the time. They're oddly
happy all the time,
godly
happy all the time.
And when they sing until they're bluish, Santa wishes he were Jewish.
Cause we're happy all the time.
Where?
Happy all the time.
We're just so happy all the time.
Weeping unto smile so wide that you can see each molar.
Sometimes they prefer to speak in rhyme.
It's sublime!
We've only been to one pole,
but they still might be bipolar.
Because we're crazy happy all the time. It's strange we're happy all the time. All change we're happy all the time.
And every single elf that has hands has to turn them into jazz hands.
Because we're happy all the time. We're happy all the time.
They're just so happy
all the time.
But there's an elf body who makes them look apathetic.
If he were any sweeter, we might end up diabetic.
He's everybody's buddy, but he'll leave your eardrums ringing.
Cause everywhere he goes, he has to tell the world he's singing.
I'm singing! It's almost Christmas and I'm singing! And I love Santa, so I'm singing!
You know, buddy, that just cuts through my head like a knife.
Oh, I'm sorry. Can I give you a hug?
Ask first, then hug. Remember? Personal space. Take a breath.
Can I sing that?
Sure.
You know I'm happy all the time. Hello, I'm happy all the time. And Christmas Town is heaven, so hello from Cloud 11. I'm so happy all the time.
Hello
and happy
all the time. All the time.
My lips are happy, my thumbs are happy, my hips are happy, my gums are happy, my cranium and my spleen is happy, and everything in between is happy. I'm happy down to the food I eat, like a penguin, I've got happy feet.
dancing. You have toys to make. The big day is only 2 weeks away. You have to pick up the pace. And don't forget, every child in the world is depending on you. No pressure.
I like attention. Making toys is so appealing that I spend each morning squealing.
Happy all the time.
Who knew I'm happy all the time?
He's a naturally happy all the time. Happy, 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 happy all the time.
Today's quota.
That's fine. Just tell me how many you made. Please?
I made 85.
85? It's 10 a.m. already and you only made 85?
No, why don't you just say it? I'm the worst toy maker in the whole wide world. I'm a cotton-headed ninny muggins.
Buddy! Buddy! You're not a cotton-headed ninny muggins. You just have talents. Special talents, in fact. Like, special talents?
You're the best basketball player in the whole North Pole.
Even better than Santa!
And you're the only baritone in the Jingle Singers. You bring us down a whole octave. In a good way.
See, buddy, you're not a cotton-headed ninny muggins. You're just special.
Yes, special.
Hey, these elves look pretty thirsty. Why don't you do a round of cocoa cart?
Yay, cocoa cart, cocoa cart!
Hey, Tiara.
Yeah, Charlie?
I hate to do this to you, but do you think you should pick up the slack on those edge sketches?
Yeah, no problem.
I appreciate it. Buddy is killing me.
Hey, that was quick thinking with the special talents thing.
Yeah, I just feel bad for the big guy. Hope he doesn't get wise.
Well, if he hasn't figured out by now that he's human, I don't think he ever will.
What? I'm human?
No, no, get Santa.
You said I'm human.
No.
No. Not you, buddy. Some other buddy. Somebody else.
No, no, I don't believe you. I'm not happy.
Good job, Tiara. You broke his heart.
What, you think I meant to do that?
This is kind of a hobby of yours, isn't it?
Charlie, do not make this about us.
My lips aren't happy, my thumbs aren't happy, my hips aren't happy, my gums aren't happy!
Buddy?
Susanna? Is it true what they said? Am I human?
Oh, well, that's a very good question. Come, sit on Santa's lap. I have to tell you a story. Oh. You are a very big boy. All right, well, once upon a time, there was a woman named Susan Wells. She had a baby. She passed away soon after he was born. Now, this baby went to an orphanage, and one Christmas night, he crawled into my toy sack, and I brought him back here by mistake. The elves raised him as one of their own.
Oh my gosh, who is it? Is it Charlie?
No, it's you, buddy. It's your story.
So, wait, I'm not an elf? An orphan? Like Annie?
No, not exactly. You had a human father, but he never knew that you were born. And, well, he lives in a faraway land called New York City. And he works right here in the Empire State Building.
In there? He must be teeny tiny.
It's actually a very tall building. Keep it. It's a gift from me.
Thanks, Santa.
All right, nothing to see here. Back to work.
Santa? What's my dad like?
Oh, he's a very successful man. He publishes children's books.
Oh.
But I must warn you, he's on the naughty list.
No! What? Why? Did he wet the bed?
No, he didn't wet the bed. He just doesn't believe in me anymore.
He doesn't believe it? Is he insane?
No, just like many human beings, they just lost their Christmas spirit.
But Christmas spirit is what makes your sleigh fly.
I know, and it's becoming a problem. Buddy, it's time you went there to meet him. I'm gonna miss you, that's for sure. But you're like a bird. A big, hairy bird. And it's time for you to leave the nest.
But I don't want to go to New York. I'm scared.
Oh, don't be scared. New York is a great place. But there's one thing that I should tell you, and it is very important.
What?
Well, there are like 7 Ray's pizzas, and they all claim to be the original. But the real one is on 6th Avenue and 11th Street.
Got it.
Okay.
Where's New York?
It's south, buddy. We're at the North Pole. Everything is south. Just go south until you hit a big, smelly, industrial wasteland.
And that's New York.
No, that's New Jersey. Just go through the Lincoln Tunnel and you're there. Come on. Bye-bye, buddy. Take care.
Bye, Santa. Oh, Santa, what's my dad's name?
Hobbs. Walter Hobbs.
Hobbs. Then I must be Buddy Hobbs. Yay!
A dad who's a million miles away. When he meets me, who knows what he'll see. But deep down I know I shouldn't be afraid, 'cause he's bound to be a lot like me. And we'll make angels in the snow till the snow begins to blow. Then we'll run inside and start a tickle fight. And if it's too cold to sled, we'll eat gingerbread instead, and then cuddle till he tucks me in at night. And we'll get our pictures taken for the Christmas cards we're making, him and me in suits of matching plaid. And when people see us walking, they'll be Google-eyed and gawking at Buddy and the world's greatest dad. Spend mornings holding hands and making plans on whether to play jacks or kick the can. Then for lunch a ginger snap, then a nap to fill the gap, between building forts and playing Superman. And if his back gives him a spasm, every good dad has them, I'll bring him cocoa and a heating pad. It's a scene inside a snow globe, it's a very apropos globe, his Buddy and the world's greatest dad. congratulations, that's quite an accomplishment. And check it out.
We'll share a whole fruit cake slice by slice, making sure not one single crumb drops.
Get out of here, freak.
And if I were to say I'm in a Christmas play, he wouldn't miss it for a million gumdrops.
Whoa!
If I fall and scrape my knee, he'll come kiss that knee for me, and he'll make that boo-boo better in a jiff. Or if I should catch a cold, or just allergies from mold, he'll disinfect me with his own handkerchief. And if ever things turn limple, I know that there's a room full of hugs and jokes to make it seem less bad. I can't hide my admiration for that perfect combination of Buddy and the world's greatest dad. So I'm gonna try my best to be everything you'd expect of me, and I promise that I won't stop until I'm done. So someday you can say I'm the world's greatest son.
Hi. I'm lost. Can you tell me where the Empire State Building is?
What do you think that is?
Whoa! Oh, that's so much bigger than I thought it would be. Santa was right! My dad works there. My dad works. I'm coming, Dad!
Jingles the Jolly Christmas Puppy is tanking in every bookstore in the country.
Why?
Because two whole pages are missing from the last chapter.
What?
Without them, the end of the book makes no sense.
Well, how did that happen?
I don't know, but you yourself okayed the final proofs. So we'll have to recall all copies and reprint.
Oh, no. Look, kids don't read books. They just look at the pictures. No recall.
Are you sure you want to do that?
No, I want to tell Greenway that we're going to take a $50,000 bath just so some stupid 5-year-old can find out what happened to Jingles the frickin' puppy on Christmas Eve.
What?
But nothing.
Whatever you say, boss.
Deb, coffee, now.
Yes, Mr. Hobbs, right away.
Hi, Darling.
Hi, Dad.
Are you ready?
Ready? Ready for what?
I don't believe this. Christmas shopping, remember?
Emily, you always do this to me.
We planned this weeks ago. I took today off.
Look, I can't. I'm swamped. You know this is the busiest time of year.
Dad, it is well documented that the children of workaholics are prone to self-esteem issues.
What can I say? The kid likes NPR.
Look, can we take this delightful conversation in my office away from the staff?
Hi. I'm here for Mr. Walter Hobbs. I'm Buddy the Elf.
Buddy the Elf? What a riot! You look hilarious. Who sent you?
Santa. From the North Pole.
Well, Mr. Hobbs will be delighted to see you, but he's in a meeting right now. Would you mind waiting a few minutes?
Uh-huh.
Stay here. Can I get you anything? Cup of coffee?
A hot chocolate would be fantastic.
Emily, you make it sound like it's my fault. I just can't. Today's impossible, isn't it, Deb?
Oh, yes, Mr. Hobbs, you have a very busy day.
1 p.m., meeting with the staff, lecture them on the board's behalf and condemn giving workers hard lunch.
My job.
job has many facets.
1:15, cut our pension size, reconvene with the union guys in between, close our Delaware branch,
and liquidize our assets.
Find a date for the meeting with Global Freight.
Try the 25th.
Walter,
wait.
No one works on that day.
See? Christmas always gets in the way.
You got it backwards.
He's right, Walter. You're the one who's always getting in the way of Christmas.
Honestly, Mrs. Hobbs, it's out of his hands.
2:30, legal wants a chat when you're through. Lecture over at NYU on outfitting Taiwan.
My daughter.
In the car, meet new sales demands. Au revoir to your dinner plans. Tell HR they'll be working till dawn.
Or else they're in hot water.
Employees under Mr. Hunt learn to please. Just to keep our jobs, we know he's more content than we say.
All together now.
Christmas always gets in the way.
What's the big brouhaha over fa-la-la-la? It's a childish ordeal. I mean flying reindeers, let's get real. Old Santa's sleigh just brings more bills to pay. So I gotta work or feel the squeeze. Money doesn't grow on Christmas trees.
Let me see that calendar. If not today, then how about tomorrow? Let's see. 1:30, buy a tree to trim, he's your son.
I remember him.
Don't make fun, there's too much to discuss.
My budget needs rewriting.
2:00, skating in the park, then a walk until after dark, here's a shock. Spend an evening with us.
Yay, Mom and Dad are fighting.
Have no doubt, it's that time of year. Think about how I'm buried here. Help me out.
It's all work and no play. Cause Christmas comes.
What does it always get?
In the way.
All right, everyone, back to work. You just came from the North Pole.
Yes, that's exactly where I just came from.
Okay, well, go on.
Go on with what?
Well, aren't you gonna sing a song or something? Or can we all just get back to work?
Yeah, a song. Yeah, sure. Yeah, anything be that. I'm singing, and I'm here with my Dad! And we never met, because he didn't know that I was born. But I'm here now, Daddy. And guess what? I love you!
Call security.
It's me, your son. Susan Wells had me, but she never told you that I exist, but I'm here now, and it's me, your son, Buddy.
Susan Wells? You said Susan Wells?
Isn't she the girl you went with in college?
Yeah, but she passed away years ago. Look, if this is supposed to be funny, it's not.
He said he's your son. Deb, who sent this Christmas gram?
I don't know, Mrs. Hobbs. He came without a gift card.
Mrs. Hobbs? Are you married to my dad?
I'm married to Mr. Hobbs.
That makes you my stepmommy! Would you like a hug?
No, really. Thank you.
Wait, he's my brother?
No, of course not.
Hey, look, Buddy, is it? All right. Some very nice people are going to come and take you away from here.
What? But I want to stay with you, Dad. Look, we have the same color eyes.
You do?
Oh, come on, they're brown! Deb has brown eyes. That doesn't make her my daughter.
Mine are blue. Actually. Ouch!
Mommy, you just pulled my hair.
I'm so sorry.
You got a problem here, Mr. Hobbs?
Yeah, can you take this elf out of here?
Will do, sir. Let's go, buddy.
That's me.
Where should we take him?
I don't know. Hey, why don't you take him back to the North Pole?
Sure thing. North Pole?
No problem. They got one at Macy's.
I just came from the North Pole. It's 3,408 miles. I walked. Can you take a look? Another one?
Have fun!
Hello, how are you today?
Fine.
Oh, that's fabulous. Oh, welcome to Macy's Jungle Passion Fruit Spray.
No.
Oh, that's fabulous. Oh, welcome to Macy's. How are you today?
I'm great. I just met my human dad.
Oh, that's fabulous. Are you an out-of-state visitor?
Yes, I'm from Christmas Town.
Oh, that's fabulous. Well, be sure to stop by our visitor services department to pick up your coupon card.
Oh, I won't be buying anything. I only have chocolate money and most of it
now. Oh, that's fabulous! Jungle Passion Fruit Spray?
For fruit spray? Sure.
Ah!
That doesn't taste like fruit at all. Hey, you, get back to work. What section did I put you in? I don't know.
You don't know.
You know what? You can work in the North Pole. Yeah. That's not the North Pole.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't.
It is.
No, it's not.
It is.
It isn't.
It is.
It isn't.
It is the snow.
Why are you smiling like that? I like smiling. Smiling's my favorite.
You know what? Let's make work your new favorite. Okay, from now on, work is your new favorite.
Yay! I love work.
Good.
Nothing makes the big guy happier than to see all his little people working hard.
Wait, did you say the big guy?
Uh-huh.
Like the big guy up north?
That's the one.
Did he send you down here?
He sure did.
God, yes. Corporate always sends somebody to check up on me.
You know what? We'll work together, me and you. We'll be pals.
Yeah.
Okay?
Okay.
All right. Now I'm gonna make a little announcement, if that's okay with you.
Of course.
All right, thank you. Attention, Macy's shoppers. We'll be closing in 5 minutes, but tomorrow morning, 10 a.m., Santa will be here.
Santa!
Oh my God! Santa? Santa here? I know him, I know him, I know him.
That's right. He'll be here to meet with all the children at 10 a.m.
10 a.m. tomorrow! 10 a.m. 10 a.m. 10 a.m. tomorrow.
Santa's coming to town.
Santa Claus is coming to town! Come here. Right here.
Why don't you help that young lady decorate that tree?
Okay. The big guy loves it when I decorate the tree at the North Pole.
I bet he does.
Oh, she's so beautiful.
Yeah, but try talking to her. She's nuts.
She is? I love nuts. Hi, I'm Buddy the Elf. We're gonna have lots of fun together.
Hi, I'm Jovi the Elf, and I seriously doubt it. You enjoying the view?
Yeah, you're really pretty. Like a glittery Christmas angel. I wish I could put you on top of the tree.
Classy. You know what? I'm not a Christmas person, so dial down the elf speak a little, okay?
Uh-oh. Sounds like someone needs to sing a Christmas carol.
Don't you know the best way to spread Christmas cheer is singing loud for all to hear?
I don't sing.
Come on, it's easy. I'm singing. I'm in a store and I'm singing. I'm in a store and I'm singing.
No. There is no singing in the North Pole.
Yes, there is. No, there isn't. Yes, there is. Big guy likes it when we sing.
He does?
Uh-huh.
I'm singing. I'm in a store and I'm singing.
No.
All right, listen up, everybody. We got a lot of work to do to get all these decorations done to prepare for the holiday rush. So be prepared to stay late.
What?
Laverne, Shirley.
You see that elf back there? Corporate sent him. He's a professional. So I need you to do whatever it is he says, even if it means staying here till midnight.
What?
Midnight? We all got lives, you know.
Then why are you dressed like an elf?
Wait. This isn't how you decorate for Christmas. Don't you care whether Santa's gonna like it or not?
Hey, take your meds and get back to work.
Decorating for Christmas isn't work, it's fun. You just gotta get into the spirit of it.
Yeah, that's it. Get into the spirit.
Yeah, all of us, together.
Yes, all of us, together.
There's a saying that we have up north that helps us put our best foot forth. If you're gonna deck the halls for Mr. C, make sure there's sparkle, jolly, twinkle, jingly.
What the heck is that supposed to be?
Just more the usual home office bull-dicky. When a room is gloomy and the atmosphere has called it quits, then you must remember that December is a time for glitz. Never stop till every limb on your Christmas tree is sparkle, jolly, twinkle, jingly. Pick up every ornament that's sitting waiting on a shelf. While you're busy decorating, why not decorate yourself? Soon you'll bring a smile to every person you see.
I'm sparkle, twinkle, jolly, what?
Close enough! And if you're at a loss, remember the phrase that says, to thine own elf be true.
To thine own elf be true.
For when it comes to Christmas display, look inside and you'll know what to do.
You'll know just what to do. Put some cheery folderol on every wall and every nook. Tinsel every corner till it's Christmas everywhere you look. In the world a holiday that's right to me. Make it sparkle, jolly, twinkle, jingly.
Thank you.
fun?
You guys did great. It looks beautiful. You know what? You can all go home. It looks great. It looks wonderful.
Gee, isn't she pretty? Why don't you ask her out?
Out?
On a date, you know. Take her out to dinner. Like,
eat food with her?
Take her out dancing, show her a good time, you know, and then take her home and
get under the covers, break out the flashlights, and eat Fluffernutter.
Whatever turns your crank, buddy.
Good night.
Wait. Would somebody like a hug?
No, would someone like a punch in the throat?
No.
So good night.
Wait, would you like do you want to eat food?
Do I want to eat food?
Yeah, like with
me. Are you asking me out on a date?
Yes, that. One of those, please.
You don't want to go out with me.
Yes, I do.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
Why?
Well, because you're really pretty. And when I'm around you, I get really warm. And my tongue swells up.
Your tongue swells up?
Yes, it does. See?
Well, it's weirdly nice I make your tongue swell up, but I just don't see this date happening.
Oh, you probably already have a date. You probably have guys asking you to eat food, lunch, dinner, all the time. I bet you have a different guy for breakfast every morning. Stupid of me to ask.
What the hell? I'm free Thursday!
Thursday! Yeah, Thursday! This will be the best Thursday in the history of Thursdays.
You know what I find? If you lower your expectations, you don't get disappointed. Don't you have a home to go to?
Yeah? Kind of a home with doors and walls, ceiling, windows, a bed. Yeah, definitely. I'm just going to stay here and put more tinsel on the tree.
Seriously? Okay, well, good night.
Good night, Jovi.
If it's too cold to sled, we'll eat gingerbread instead, and then cuddle till he tucks me in at night.
Here, open up the doors and let in the kids. Oh, sweet mother.
Oh, Merry Christmas! Merry
Santa.
Christmas!
Santa's me, it's Buddy!
Hey, yo, Buddy, how you doing?
Santa's me! Who the heck are you?
What are you talking about? I'm Santa Claus.
Are you not?
Yeah, I am. Oh.
No, you're not.
Hey, come on. What do you want for Christmas, Sonny?
I want Zombie Apocalypse 4. Rivers of Blood.
Don't tell him what you want. He's a liar.
Beat it, Zippy.
I want Zombie Apocalypse 4. Rivers of Blood.
You can't have that. It's too violent.
I wasn't talking to you, Mother.
You
disgust me. You don't smell like Santa. You smell like beef and cheese.
That's a good talk, huh?
You sit on a throne of lies.
Not kidding. Get out of here, huh? Hey, what were you saying, kid?
I want Zombie Apocalypse 4. Rivers of Blood.
It's reprehensible.
You're reprehensible.
You're a fake.
Oh, I'm a fake? I'm a fake. How would you like to be dead, huh?
That's it! He's not even saying! He's gonna be...
Get out of my store! I'm Santa now!
How? How? How?
Wait! Don't run so fast! Santa can't run that fast!
That's not Santa! He's a liar! And a fraud!
Calm down! Tell us your name!
I'm Buddy the Elf!
You got a last name, Buddy the Elf?
I do! I'm Buddy Hobbs! You know my dad, Walter Hobbs?
No! But we will locate him while you are sitting in a cell cooling your heels.
Oh, thanks. My heels are incredibly sweaty. But how do you even know?
Heck, it still doesn't work.
Maybe you've got this spinny thing on backwards.
I don't know. Dad said he'd help me, but he's not around. Again, he's basically not a dad.
Michael, don't say that. Your father loves you. He's a very caring man. He just... Hold that thought.
Hi, Mom! I'm home!
Excuse me?
Is this the Walter Hobbs residence?
Yes!
Our pal Buddy here says that Mr. Hobbs is his dad.
Yes, officer, we're aware that Buddy thinks he's Mr. Hobbs' son.
Well, I guess we came to the right place. Let's go!
Wait a second, you can't just leave him here.
Hey, lady, have a heart. It's almost Christmas, and he's homeless.
Well...
Okay, bye, Buddy!
Bye, Vinny. Bye, Doug. Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
I can stay here? Yay, I can stay here!
Yes, but just for tonight, then you're gonna have to find a place of your own.
Oh, but I like it here.
It's the model of a wind turbine machine.
You know what it is?
Yeah, I made a few of them before in Santa's workshop.
A few of them? How many?
Only about 7,000. But this one is pretty weird looking. I don't think Santa would okay this.
So you know Santa pretty well, do you?
Well, Santa's like my best friend.
You still believe in all that flying reindeer nonsense?
Of course not. Santa hasn't used flying reindeer for years and years. Ever since he got that nasty letter from PETA. Nowadays, the sleigh is powered Christmas spirit alone. Which is a problem because of people like you. I mean, look at this place. No tinsel, no tree. I bet you two haven't even written your letters to Santa Claus yet.
Buddy, I think I'm a little old to be writing letters to Santa Claus.
Me too. Way too old. Anyhow, I'm gonna flunk if I can't get this stupid science project working.
I got an idea. How about you two muster up the Christmas spirit to go write your letters to Santa Claus? And I'll fix your wind machine.
You will?
Uh-huh.
Well, okay then. It's a deal. Okay, Mom?
Okay, Mom.
Okay. So, how do we do this?
You're asking your 12-year-old son how to write a letter to Santa Claus. What does that say about this family, Mom?
All right, Dr. Drew, settle down. So, in the spirit of Christmas, what do you want for Christmas?
I don't know. I only know what I don't want for Christmas. I don't want a check that's made out to cash or a corporate free gift from some secret stash. I'd like a day with my dad.
Just a day.
Make that two. If you can do that, Santa, I'll believe in you.
I don't want a trip to some hip salon or a trendy perfume I'll never put on. I'd like to feel like he cares,
even if it's not true.
If you can do that, Santa, I'll believe in you. Even though it's been years since you've heard from me, I thought it was worth a shot. If it's true that you're magic, I guarantee we could use all the magic you've got.
I can get you some cookies if that's what it takes. I've heard stories and I know the deal. You just slide down the chimney and fix our mistakes. Now if only I thought you were real. If you were real.
I guess that's our list. Our letter is done.
Is it really a list? If it adds up to one, make it part of our lives, not just passing through. If you can do that, Santa, I'll believe in you. Yes, if you do that, Santa,
staying with us? What do you mean? And turn that thing off.
Just for tonight, the police showed up with him.
The police? Oh, dear God.
Dad, please, look at this.
Michael, not now.
Michael, why don't you show Buddy the spare room? You can sleep there. It has a futon.
A futon?
It's a kind of bed.
Oh, I thought it was like a robot. I am futon. I am futon.
I am futon.
Emily, there is no way. He can't possibly stay here.
Walter, it's freezing out and he's homeless. We can't just put him out in the street.
Well, hey, there's that youth hostel down by the West Side Highway. He can stay there.
What a good idea. We can stick him in a cab and send him to a youth hostel in an elf costume. Or we could just save the cab fare and beat him up here.
All right, fine. But one night and that's it. And I want him out of here by 8 a.m.
Wow, buddy. Leftover spaghetti for breakfast is the best, huh?
I've never even had spaghetti before.
No way.
Yes way. At the North Pole, we only eat from the five major food groups. Cookies, candy canes, candy corn, and syrup. But
Something here is missing.
Syrup! Never leave home without it.
You like sugar, huh?
Is there sugar in maple syrup?
Yes.
Then yes!
You do know that sugar's bad for your teeth, right?
Of course. That's why it's important to chew your sugar carefully, drink lots of syrup, and see your dentist twice a day.
God.
Emily, the lunatic is still here.
Yes, and he's not going anywhere.
What are you talking about?
Walter, I've been, very busy the last couple of days. You see, I had to yank a strand out of Buddy's hair. Then, as planned, wait till you're not there. Sneak in and find your hair on the sink.
Someone's been multitasking.
Then I check with my cousin Mel. He's a tech at Beth Israel.
Wait a sec. Should I call you a shrink?
No, dear, but thanks for asking. Melvin checks all the DNA. It's complex, but he works all day. This FedEx shows up here when he's done.
And?
Walter has an elf for a son.
Oh, no.
Daddy!
I got a big brother. This is so cool. I can't believe it.
He can't believe it. What are we going to do now? He can't stay with us. He's insane.
Daddy, I planned out our whole first day together. Just you and me. First, we'll make snow angels for 2 hours. Then we'll go ice skating, and then we'll eat a whole log of Toll House cookie dough as fast as we can. And then we'll come home and we'll snuggle.
Oh my God. Look, buddy, we're gonna have to snuggle some other time because I've gotta go to work today. So today, you can stay with your stepmommy.
Oh, no, we won't. I've got my annual planning meeting this morning. Your father will stay here with you.
Emily, I am this close to being fired.
Then take him to work with you. I'm sure he can be very helpful around the office.
I can't believe this is happening. Well, look, if you're going to come with me, you got to lose the costume. We'll stop at Brooks Brothers on the way. Get you a new suit.
Can it be red? Like Santa's?
No.
Oh, can I come? You could drop me off at school on the way.
Fine, but that's half the morning lost.
Come on, let's go tell Francisco the doorman to flag us a cab.
Francisco? Oh, that's such a fun name to say. Francisco.
He's an idiot. My son's an idiot.
Walter, tell me something. Was Susan a bright girl?
Oh, yeah, the brightest. Phi Beta Kappa.
Well, I guess we know where he got the idiot gene then, don't we, darling?
Iceman Hobbs? Oh, and get this. It turns out there were consequences. Uh-huh. He's 6'2". He's incredibly sweet, which is bizarre considering the bloodline. Oh, but here's the kicker. He thinks that he... Uh-oh. The Iceman cometh!
Sarah. I like your purple dress. It's very purpley.
Congratulations, buddy. I hear, it turns out, you're actually Mr. Hobbs' son.
Yeah. Oh, Deb, you look so pretty. You should be on a Christmas card.
Oh, stop it. I hardly recognize you.
Yeah, it's because I'm wearing human work clothes.
Look at me. I'm wearing a suit, approximately like my dad's. And you'll see, suspenders to boot, my dad's up on the latest fad. We're like two peas in a pod, so don't think it odd if I should go out on a limb and say when I grow up, I'm gonna be just like him.
Mr. Greenway arrived from Chicago about an hour ago. He should be here any minute.
Today of all days.
Today of all days.
I'm gonna need coffee now.
Don't let me do it. Me, pick me.
And I knew I never regret coming from so far away. Though it's true, we've not cuddled yet. It's bound to happen any day. It's monkey see, monkey do. I follow his cue.
Hi, Jim.
Hi, Jim!
Yep, when I grow up, I'm gonna be just like him.
Will you put Jim down, please?
I already have a boyfriend.
Well, you can never have too many boyfriends.
Deb, make yourself useful.
Oh, buddy, why don't you help me put these documents through the shredder?
What's a shredder?
Oh, it's a machine that makes snow.
No way!
We go together like sugar and plum.
A perfect duo like crumb cake and rum.
I found my rock, a Gibraltar cup,
Mr. Walter Hobbs.
Why don't we make him some snow?
Why make him some? Make him gobs!
Back to work!
What in the elf? What's your favorite color?
Honey, I need you to sit over here.
Okay.
Read this. I'm very busy, so please don't talk. Dad? What? Why is the sky blue? I don't know. Has something about sun and ultraviolet something? I don't know.
Dad?
What?
What does a rainbow feel like?
How? I don't know. Soft?
Susan Wells?
Buddy, that was a long time ago. Look, we were just kids in college. We drifted apart. She never told me about... She was fun. Full of life. You'd have liked her.
Mr. Greenway, sir.
Hobbs! My phone has been ringing off the hook. Angry mothers, kids crying. What happened to Jingles, the jolly Christmas puppy? Did he make it to the North Pole? Did he ever find his magic bone?
Yeah, that was a really unfortunate oversight. But I'm fully prepared to blame my staff.
Don't try to pass the buck. It's your name on these proofs. And I'll tell you something else. Even if those two missing pages had been in there, the book still would have sucked. You're hanging by a thread, Hobbs.
Hi, Mr. Greenway. I'm Buddy the Elf.
What? Who the devil is that?
He's my son.
I thought your son was 12 years old.
Oh, I'm 30. That's this many.
What?
Deb? Buddy needs a break. Would you please take him downstairs and get him some hot chocolate?
Can I have a chocolate monster?
What's a chocolate monster?
It's hot cocoa, but you put a chocolate bar on top, so that when the chocolate bar melts, it gets even more chocolatey!
Hobbs, you're out of a job unless you can come up with a blockbuster idea for a new Christmas book. I mean a through-the-roof national bestseller!
Well, sir, that's a lot easier said than done.
Yes, it is. So you better put your top writers on it. Because I will be back in New York on the evening of December 24th. At that time, you will present to me in exact detail your plans for the book. Happy holidays, Hobbs!
God, I'm a good guy. Basically. Can you throw me a bone here?
No!
Chocolate monster?
liking your dinner.
Greasy souvlaki on a stick is not dinner.
But it's the world's best souvlaki.
No, it's the world's crappiest souvlaki. Sorry.
No, thank you for the feedback. I'm gonna go home right now and change the sign.
Look, how about we just call it a night?
No, there's still so much more we have to do on our date. It's too early to take you home and get you under the covers, so what about dancing?
No.
I'll go first. Ein, zwei, drei, vier! Take it, Toby!
I'm so not going to take that.
Then what about bells? Bells, bells! Can I borrow these?
Oh!
Thank you. Thanks. I used to be in a band. It was me on the bells, Charlie on the toy piano, and Tiara on lead vocals in Glockenspiel. We had a pretty good thing going until Charlie started to hit the syrup really hard. Oh, those were crazy, crazy days. Oh, did I mention? You look miraculous.
Miraculous, huh? Well, you look miraculous, too. That elf getup made you look incredibly dorky.
Thanks!
That wasn't a compliment.
Oh, I know! Today is the night before the night before Christmas. Let's do something Christmassy!
You want Christmassy? Huh? Okay, follow me!
Neither am I. Santa says that I'm a hazard. He calls me Edward Scissorfeet.
Stop. Let's make a pact. If you try to be less elfy, I'll try to be less crabby.
Okay. I'd like it if you were less crabby.
I came here last year, too. My first Christmas in New York.
Oh, where'd you come from?
L.A.
L.A.? Never heard of it. I don't think Santa goes there.
He doesn't. Christmases there are surreal. No snow.
No snow?
I've never even seen snow. I've always wanted to.
Oh, that's gotta be the saddest thing that I've ever heard.
Yeah, you know, when I was a kid, I dreamed of having a snowy Christmas Eve dinner at Tavern on the Green with Billy Crystal. That sounds stupid.
No, it doesn't. Who's Billy Crystal? He sounds magic.
He's one of my favorite actors. He's in one of my favorite movies of all time. City Slickers? Anyway, last year I spent Christmas in a 400-square-foot studio apartment with no heat, binge-watching Gilmore Girls on Netflix. Sad, huh?
This year, we'll make your Christmas dream come true by having dinner at Tavern on the Green.
Oh, I don't think so. For one thing, it's been closed for months. It only just reopened, and now it's even harder to get in.
My dad can get us a table. He can do anything!
Buddy, don't promise things you can't deliver.
I will make your Christmas dream come true, Jovi. I promise.
Wow. I might actually have a real Christmas after all.
See, you have some Christmas spirit.
I guess I do. A little.
Well, now you just have to spread it around. And everybody knows the best way to spread Christmas cheer is singing loud for all to hear.
I told you I don't sing.
What do you mean you don't sing?
I mean I don't sing for anyone at any time under any circumstances, and that includes birthdays, bar mitzvahs, and especially Christmas, okay?
Come on, Jovi, singing can be easy.
Please stop.
It's fun, it's free, and best of all, it's...
totally cheesy?
All you have to do is move your voice up higher. High, low, high, low.
High, it's just like talking, only you sustain it and you make it sound pretty.
No.
Just sing a Christmas song. It's like magic if things go wrong. Just spread some Christmas cheer by singing loud groan. Do you hear?
People are staring.
That's the point! Just sing a Christmas song and keep on singing all season long. Think of the joy you'll bring if you just close your eyes and sing. And if you're short on cheer, think about that year you woke up to find a brand new snow had fallen. The ornaments you made way back in second grade, untangling the Christmas lights, took your father several nights. Your mother claimed that she had proof. There were reindeer on the roof. Remember who you were back then. Let those moments live again.
Come on, Jovi, try it.
Just sing a Christmas song. It's like magic if things go wrong. Just spread some Christmas cheer by singing loud for all to hear.
Sing a Christmas song and keep on singing all season long.
To
think of the joy you'll bring if you just close your eyes. If you just close your eyes. If you just close your eyes.
What about this? A town fully populated by tomatoes.
Tomatoes.
Yeah, little tomato people, busily preparing for Christmas. But little do they know, the mean old tomato who lives at the top of the mountain is prepared to steal Christmas this year.
You're describing the Grinch.
But with tomatoes.
You're an idiot, Chadwick. Look, Greenway is going to fire us all unless we come up with something really good. Do you understand that? Do you appreciate the seriousness of the situation? And where's Matthews?
He's working a lead.
He's what?
I got it.
You got it?
An original idea, I hope?
We have something better than an idea.
We got a book.
You're familiar, of course, with
Christopher Smith.
Are you kidding? When you think of Christopher Smith, I mean, he's like the greatest writer of Christmas stories who ever lived.
So you'd be happy if we brought him in?
He's dead, you morons.
Mr. Hobbs, I met this guy who deals in used furniture, high-end stuff, from the home's prominent dead writers. So he recently acquired a desk owned by one Christopher Smith.
And within this desk, he finds a secret drawer.
And in this drawer, he finds manuscripts.
A lost Christmas Christmas story!
A lost Chris Smith Christmas story?
It's a Chris Smith Christmas for Walter Hobbs!
Oh my God. This is beautiful. Oh,
isn't it? The illustrations.
Oh, and the story will make you cry.
I can't believe I'm holding an original Christopher Smith in my hands.
Careful, it's the only copy.
What? Are you nuts? What if somebody spills coffee on it? Make a copy!
Relax. The machine's out of toner. Deb's changing it now. Just be careful with it, Mr. Hobbs.
This could be huge.
I'm in love! I'm in love! And I don't care who knows it.
Buddy, we're really busy right now.
Dad, I need a table at Tavern on the Green, 7 p.m., Christmas Eve, and $400.
Mr. Hobbs, the guy's waiting in the lobby.
Look, buddy, we'll get to you in a minute, but for right now, can you just sit here and amuse yourself?
Okay, Dad.
All right, hey, guys, bring the guy up. I really want to thank him.
He's not waiting for a thank you. He's waiting for $300,000.
What?
It's a small price to pay, Mr. Hobbs. It's a modern classic.
We'll make it back on the film rights alone.
I don't know. That's a lot of money.
Mr. Hobbs, we've been trying to come up with an idea for a story, but we got nothing.
We're idiots.
And then this comes along. It's like a gift from God.
And God gets mad when you don't accept his gifts.
Mm-hmm. All right, I'll write the check. Look, Greenway will understand, right? In fact, I bet he'll be thrilled. We'll end up with making millions off this. I bet there'll be Christmas bonus for everyone.
No!
Oh my God!
Buddy, what have you done? That was the only copy.
What?
Look, I can't take this anymore. Go back to the apartment, pack up your things, and leave.
Where for?
I don't care. I don't care where you go. I don't care that you're an elf. I don't care that you're my son. Just get out of my life forever.
I only try my best to be so he could expect of me, but I let you down, and so I guess we're done. And now how can I say I'm the world's greatest son?
Thank you.
Sorry, I just had to make a quick stop to the cocoa cart, if you know what I mean. Single malt cocoa. That sure will curl your shoes. All right. Where were we? Ah, yes. Buddy was not having a very merry Christmas. In fact, it was the worst one that he could remember. Even worse when those elves had that winter vomiting disease. Well, it wasn't after Walter said all of those terrible things to him, Buddy went back to the apartment. And he put on his elf suit, and he wrote a note.
Dear Dad and Mom and Michael, I'm sorry I ruined your lives. And I also feel real upset about pouring that bottle of maple syrup into your DVD player. My bad. Anyway, thanks for the nifty suit and coat, but I won't be needing them anymore. I don't belong here with you. I don't belong at the North Pole either. I'll never forget you. Love, and goodbye forever, Buddy. P.S. Merry Christmas.
After that, Buddy wandered all night and all the next day, cold and alone through the streets of the city. By then he was hungry, and he happened to stumble upon the only place in New York where a sad elf can get a cheap meal on Christmas Eve. Christmas season I thought would never end.
It gets longer every year.
Man, are you telling me? I had a bruise on my thigh in the shape of a kid's butt.
Am I late?
Nah, we still got chop suey and moo-goo guy pan and all.
If I ever have to wear this suit again.
Tough year.
What am I shugging at Christmas?
Hi. Is this a Chinese restaurant?
No, I just got a thing for dragons.
Sorry, I'll keep looking.
Oh, no, you're too depressed for sarcasm, huh? Come on in, honey. We got a special on for out-of-work Christmas temps. You like hot and sour soup?
No.
Hey. That's that crazy elf I was talking about.
The guy who beat up Larry Spinoli?
Hey, he didn't beat me up.
Hey, buddy! Come on over here. Sit with us Santas.
I know none of you are real Santas, but I'm not gonna beat you up. Promise. My mom told me about you guys and how you're here for the kids who can't go up to the North Pole to see the real Santa. Yeah, I get it now. You make a lot of kids happy.
Not anymore.
Years ago, kids used to line up when they saw you. You felt special, you know?
Now they just sit on your lap and text.
People got no respect.
They ain't got no respect at all.
No respect.
No respect for Santa Claus.
Used to be, I stand on the busiest corner, ring my bell and make the people smile. Now a days they pass me by, and who knows why? Could it be that old Saint Nick's gone out of style?
Well, nobody cares about Santa. They made their list. You get dismissed, 'cause nobody cares about Santa Claus.
Now they think I'm just passé, some old cliche, and it makes me wonder why I even try.
Well, nobody cares, nobody cares, nobody cares about Santa. He wants for a beer.
Now they end off your beer.
Cause nobody cares about Santa Claus.
To see me again.
Ah, forget about it. That's what Christmas is all about, fighting with your family.
Yeah, that's what presents are for. Making up.
There you go. Go get your old man a present.
A present?
Yeah. You know, when you were a kid, it was all about getting presents. Now, grown up, it's about what you can give. Underwear, socks,
a Snuggie.
It's the one time of year we all get to be Santa.
Present. Thanks, guys.
Speaking of which, it's Christmas Eve. I should probably get the wife a gift. I wonder if the Walgreens is still open.
Wait, it's Christmas. It's Christmas Eve. Oh no, Jovi! I forgot all about Jovi. Y'all, Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
choice in men has always been pathetic, I suppose. The guy who stole my credit cards, the guy who tried on my clothes. And so a row of self-help books line my bedroom shelf. Well, there's one rule those books forgot: you never fall in love with an elf. His endless talk of Christmas Town will test your every nerve. Still, he's kind of cute, I guess. Well, if you grade on a curve, and though you'd vowed you'd never sing, just look at yourself. You're halfway through a Christmas song called Never Fall in Love with an Elf. The holidays will seem bittersweet while you're alone in bed. But how can one girl ever compete with a magic fat guy in a flying?
More miraculous than ever.
And you look seasonally appropriate.
Thanks.
You are 2.5 hours late.
I have a really good explanation.
Go ahead.
I forgot about our date.
That's your explanation? You forgot?
For a really long time I forgot, but then I remembered, which is why I'm late. Is this Tavern on the Green? With all the lights? It's really pretty.
Yeah, I'm sure some wonderful couple had a lovely evening sitting at our table.
No, they didn't.
Why not?
We didn't have a table. I was gonna ask my dad to get us one.
But you forgot.
No, I remembered. He just got really mad at me when I made it snow in his office.
Stop! Just stop! I can't take any more of your crazy stories.
No, Dovey, but it's true. I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to ruin your Christmas dream.
Forget it. It's my fault. I knew you couldn't get us a table, and still I got all dressed up and came here, and an hour went by, and another, and I waited. I didn't leave. Why? Because our date on Thursday was the only good time I've had in the last year and a half. How sad is that?
That is sad. But it's kind of happy, too.
I just thought that if anyone could give me a real Christmas, it would have been you. Lower your expectations so you don't get disappointed. I should have that tattooed on my forehead.
Oh, Jovi, I feel so bad about this. It's sick to my stomach, like I swallowed a zillion sticks of juicy fruit. The last thing I wanted in the whole wide world was to hurt you.
I don't want to talk about it anymore. I'm cold and my feet are killing me in these heels.
Can I at least you a Christmas present?
This is the worst possible time.
Here. This is what New York City looks like when it snows. Shake it. It's pretty, huh? But real snowflakes are smaller than buildings. Keep it. And look at it when you're not furious with me. It's real special. I know you're not gonna believe me, but Santa Claus gave it to me when I left the North Pole.
Buddy, I so wish that were true. Goodbye. Belong at the North Pole either. Nobody wants me. Nobody needs me. Ugh, that poor thing wandering the streets in that dorky elf suit.
Why did he do it?
He had a fight with your father. This really is amazing. I can barely draw a straight line on one of these things.
We have to find him. We have to bring him home.
We will find him, but then I think we need to get him some help.
What do you mean help?
Professional help. Honey, Buddy is crazy.
Mom.
No, he is. We have to accept that.
He's my brother.
I know. You have a crazy brother. Lots of people do.
Just because someone believes in Santa Claus doesn't mean they're crazy.
Yes, it does.
No, it doesn't.
Yes, it does.
What about little kids? Are they crazy too?
That's different. If a little kid believes in a talking purple dinosaur, it's delightful. If he still believes in it when he's 30, it's profoundly disturbing. Look. Just because Buddy is crazy doesn't mean we love him any less. I have a friend, Barry, the psychiatrist. You remember, the one with the Ferrari? I'm gonna give him a call, see if he can tell us where we should look for Buddy.
Buddy, where did you go? Mom! Mom!
What?
I saw a tiny sleigh make its tiny way right across the sky.
What?
There wasn't time to think. There wasn't time to blink before it zoomed right by. Everything I knew, and everything that you knew too is absolutely now untrue because without a doubt there is a Santa Claus.
Oh my God! I just saw him too, yet my whole life through, he seemed fake to me. Couldn't Santa see what a fantasy he appeared to be? And everything I thought is tangled up in one big knot. The world out there has clearly got its flaws. If they can't say there is a Santa Claus.
Guides him through the night.
The beard like snow, the ho ho ho.
I told you I was right.
And does this mean that Easter eggs are hidden by a rabbit? I just thought that I'd been hocus pocus. And does this mean there's any truth to a fairy who might buy your tooth?
Come on, Mother, let's stay focused.
Oh my God!
Or keep your head on straight when fairy tales come true. No, I can't complain, 'cause if I'm insane, that means you are too. So why don't we make a pact, a solemn pledge to be exact, that Santa's real, in fact.
All right, so you have to work on Christmas Eve. Tough luck, so do I. Look, if Greenway does not buy our pitch, we are all going to be fired.
But we have been at this all night.
We don't have a pitch.
I'm painfully aware of that. Just keep thinking.
What about this? A poor family of asparagus children, busily awaiting Santa, but they're self-conscious about the way their pee smells.
I'd like your resignation on my desk in the morning. But for now, just keep thinking.
May I make a suggestion?
Please, anything.
Whenever I would visit my granny in Budapest, she would tell us the story of little Palko, the one-legged boy, and he would wish and wish every year for a new leg, and then one year, there it was, under the Christmas tree, from Santa.
A leg?
Yes, a leg.
A human leg?
Yes, because he'd been a very good boy.
That's the most disgusting story I've ever heard.
Well, it's incredibly touching when you hear it in Hungarian. Walter!
Dad, you are not gonna believe what just happened.
Emily, for God's sakes, you know, I need the time to get through this pitch.
Walter, we have to talk right now.
Dad, go look out for Greenway, please. Okay, what?
First of all, Buddy is missing.
He ran away and he left a note on an Etch-a-Sketch.
I tried to bring it in the cab, but you know, the slightest shake and these darn things erase themselves.
Look. Tonight of all nights, I just
gotta... I knew it! He's not gonna help us!
But, Michael, you don't understand!
No! You don't understand! It's not just Buddy! Me and Mom both saw...
Mr. Greenway! How lovely to see you! Would you like a hot buttered rum? Maybe a double?
No. Where's Hobbs?
Please, I just need 10 minutes to get through this pitch, and then I'll look for Buddy. I'll look for any elf you want me to.
Okay, make it quick. I had to catch a plane back to Chicago.
Christmas party?
Hardly. You remember Marzenko in Acquisitions? He gave some con artist $300,000 of company money for a fake Christmas!
What a loser.
You should fire that guy.
All right, let's hear your pitch, Hobbs. And it had better be good.
Okay, all right. Let's start with the cover. Picture this. It's a Christmas tree. And under the Christmas tree, we find a little boy's leg.
Hey, Dad.
Oh, buddy, buddy, we were so worried about you. Are you okay?
Well, I think I just broke up with my girlfriend.
Aw, you have a girlfriend? Buddy, the most amazing thing happened.
Can we please do this later?
Dad, I know you're mad at me, so I want to make it up to you.
Hobbs, what is your family doing here? This is a business meeting.
So I'm going to get you a Christmas present. Now, I don't have any money, so your options are 1,000 butterfly kisses or a bracelet made of my hair.
Neither. Look, if you want to get me a present, give me a story to pitch.
What? Are you telling me you don't have a story to pitch?
No, of course I have a story to pitch. It's about little Palko. A one-legged boy who grows up in an asparagus patch.
Dad!
Yeah, no. You can't. Not now.
But Dad, I have a story. And this is a way better present than a bracelet made of my hair.
Yeah, go ahead. No, I can't.
Go ahead. It can't be any worse than little Palko, the one-legged asparagus boy.
It all starts on a Christmas morning about 30 years ago.
page. One, fresh out of toys, Santa makes his way back. When he hears a small noise from inside of his pack, a sound that's not unlike a baby's cry, it's enough to leave the jolly guy perplexed. And?
Come on, buddy, what comes next?
A baby inside Santa's bag. It's not a bad start.
Hey, he's buying it. Keep going.
Page two, back from his ride, Santa gathers his elves.
He gathers his elves.
They quickly decide they'll raise the baby themselves. The North Pole isn't made for humans, though, and soon the phony elf begins to grow so tall.
He
learns he's human after all.
Right, good one, Dad.
That's it's the story of
Buddy the Elf. It's the story of Buddy the Elf.
It's the story of. It's kind of brilliant if I say so myself.
It's the story of Buddy the Elf.
So the baby finds out he's a human. Then what?
Well, then he goes to New York, and...
Page three, his father's at work, and Buddy walks through the door. His dad is sort of a jerk, and Buddy's banned from the floor.
His father is not prepared to be a dad to a son he never knew he had.
But soon, he'll be forced to change his tune.
He'll be forced to change his tune.
It's the story of
Buddy the Elf. It's the story of Buddy the Elf. It's the story of. It's kind of brilliant if he says so himself. It's the story of Buddy the Elf.
And maybe Buddy helps his dad in a setting much like this.
Maybe his father learns a son is something he can't dismiss.
They might learn that they need each other much more than they know.
Maybe the point of the story is never too late to grow.
Story of Buddy, the story of Mary, that is the man who saved the girl, and loves the fire.
a lot.
Just one little thing. Instead of an elf, let's make it a horse.
Excuse me?
I want it to be a horse instead of an elf.
You mean a horse like a...
With a saddle and tail?
Yeah, a horse.
Interesting. Why?
Market research. Horses score really big with tweens.
Gweens?
Girl, tweens.
So let me understand this. You want our Christmas story to be about a horse that grows up in the North Pole.
Yeah. At least it's going to take a little tweaking.
Genius.
It's outside the box.
There is no box.
It's the stupidest thing I've ever heard.
Michael.
You're an idiot.
That's it. Ah, what's up with these sons of yours?
Mr. Greenway.
Oh, come on. Buddy the Christmas horse.
Sir, I am not a horse.
I've had enough of this. I don't need to be lectured by kids on how to sell kids' books to kids. You two, take your smart aleck remarks and get out of here.
Sorry.
No, wait. Mr. Greenway, Michael and Buddy are my sons. I'd prefer it if you didn't insult them.
And I'd prefer to keep your wife and your whole weirdo family out of the office and do your job. Now, you've got a good idea here, Hobbs. With work, could be a million seller. So here's what we're going to do. I'm going to cancel my flight to Chicago. We're going to work all night and all day tomorrow until we get
tomorrow. Tomorrow's Christmas.
You got a problem with that?
Yes, I do. I quit.
What?
I quit.
Let me get this straight. You want to spend Christmas Day on the unemployment line?
No, I want to spend Christmas Day with my family. But I'll be happy to spend it anywhere as long as it's not with you.
All right, Dad!
Yay, Daddy!
You're weak, Hobbs. I haven't spent Christmas with my family in 30 years. That's why I'm president of this company and you're nobody.
Mr. Greenway?
What?
Have a Merry Christmas.
I quit. I actually quit my job.
I've never been more proud of you, Walter.
Oh, Buddy, we saw him. We saw Santa Claus.
You did?
We did. He was in the sleigh with the bag of toys, the whole bit. And then he landed right in the middle of Central Park, Walter. It
Wait.
Was the most incredible.
He landed?
Yeah, right by the boathouse.
Wait, why would he do that? Unless he couldn't find a sleigh anymore. Oh, no, Santa was worried about this. Come on, we have to help him.
Michael, Buddy, wait for your dad.
Depend on the children, they'd believe, and I'd be skyward bound. Now it seems there's not enough belief around to get me and my sleigh up off the ground. I gave it a try. How can I fly when nobody cares about
Santa?
Buddy, am I ever glad to see you? The darn sleigh won't fly.
I know.
In this whole city, there's not enough Christmas spirit.
Tell me about it.
8 million people that don't believe in me. A guy can't help but take that personally.
But I believe in you, and so does my little brother.
I mean, it's the same every year. I get a boost over Vermont, and as soon as I hit the tri-state area, it's lights out, like I'm in a black hole. But I've never crashed before.
Oh, Santa, I have so much to tell you about.
Buddy, you shouldn't have run off like that.
Dad, Mom, Michael, I'd like you to meet my bestest friend in the whole wide world, Mr. Santa Claus.
Oh, my God.
Walter, that's the guy. That's the guy we saw flying right past our window. That's him right there.
Santa Claus.
Why, hello, Michael. I got your letter.
You did?
I sure did. It's over here in my iPad. I used to schlep along this huge book of Christmas wishes, but not anymore. Let's see here. Nope, that's Candy Crush. Yes. Letters to Santa. Michael Hobbs. All I want for Christmas is a day with my dad. A real tearjerker.
I can't wait to tell the guys at school about this. They'll freak.
Mr. Claus, I have to tell you, I am a huge, huge fan. I mean, I loved you. I think I do again. I loved you in Miracle on 34th Street.
And this is my dad.
So, Walter, can I take you off the naughty list or not?
Look, this has been a crazy week. Found out I had a son who was raised by elves. I told off my boss, I quit my job. I'm a little disoriented right now.
Dad, that is the real Santa Claus in front of you.
Look, I'm just... You want to know what? It doesn't make a difference if I can't wrap my head around all this. What's important is, buddy, if you believe in Santa Claus, then I believe in Santa Claus.
Well, that's good enough for me. You're off the naughty list.
Yeah! Look at the sleigh!
Oh. It's not enough. I sure could use a few magic reindeer about now. Thank you, PETA. Well, that's it.
What?
I mean, that's it. It's over. I guess I'm going to have to look into another line of business. My brother-in-law, he has a Culver's in Boca.
Santa!
I don't mean I'm going to work there. I'm talking about a franchise. Now, don't look at me like that. If nobody believes in Santa anymore, what can I do? It's going to break my heart to disappoint all these kids.
Well, I'm not going to give up. I know I can get you all the Christmas spirit you need. I just need to talk to enough people. I'm going to need this.
Hey, wait, I haven't backed that up yet.
Charlotte Denon, NY1, continuing our live coverage from Central Park. No evidence has yet been found of the UFO that apparently crashed in the park earlier this evening. But could there be another explanation? Perhaps what you millions of New York One viewers saw was Santa Claus making his rounds above the skies of Manhattan, delivering toys to all good little...
That's exactly what the people saw! Except Santa's sleigh crashed because there isn't enough Christmas spirit!
It seems one of Santa's elves has joined us.
Yeah, I know. Everybody in New York seems to think that I'm crazy. But I'm here to tell you that Santa is real!
Well, I'm afraid that's all we have time for.
No, I can prove it. I have his iPad right here. You, sir, what's your name?
I'm David Lambert!
David Lambert, L-A-L-A-M. Okay, here. 1979, you got a red Schwinn bicycle with a bell shaped like Miss Piggy.
What? How did you know that?
And you, ma'am, what's your name?
Emma Von Brocklin.
Emma Von Brocklin. V-O-V-O-N. Here we go. Emma Von Brocklin, in 1960, you got a Bobby Rydell lunchbox.
I loved my Bobby Rydell.
What is this? Some kind of trick?
No, it's all in here. What's your name?
Charlotte Denon, New York One.
Charlotte Denon, New York One. All right, right here. It says, this year for Christmas, you want a Tiffany engagement ring and your boyfriend Dwayne to stop dragging his feet and pop the question.
Who told you to say that? My mother?
No, it's all in here.
All right, that's it. I don't know how you're doing this, but I'm not an idiot. Everybody knows that there is no Santa Claus. Oh my God, I ruined Christmas!
You didn't ruin Christmas. Nobody can. It's all around you.
I could sit here and read names and gifts out of this thing all day. You still wouldn't believe in him, would you? Well, that's okay. Christmas is about a whole lot more than just Santa Claus. Christmas is sleeping on a futon, or having cold spaghetti for breakfast with your little brother. It's about going ice skating with your girlfriend and kissing her for the first time under a big, glittery Christmas tree. It's traveling miles and miles to be with your family, running through the Lincoln Tunnel, cars blowing their horns, and truck drivers yelling things that no human being should say to another person, let alone an elf. Also that you can be with your family on Christmas Day. It's hoping that on Christmas morning, when you wake up, all the cars and all the big gray office buildings and all the piles of garbage are covered in snow. See? You can't ruin Christmas. It's all around you. You just have to get into the spirit of it. And everybody knows the best way to spread Christmas cheer is singing loud for all to hear. So come on, everybody. Sing. Everybody, sing! Anybody?
Just sing a Christmas song. It's like magic when things go wrong. Just spread some Christmas cheer by singing loud for all to hear.
Come on, people, get into it!
Jovi. You're here. I thought you were mad at me.
I was. But then you made it snow.
Just sing a Christmas song and keep on singing all season long. Think of the joy you'll bring if you just close your eyes and sing. Just sing a Christmas song. It's like magic if things go wrong. Just spread some Christmas cheer by singing loud for all to hear.
Just sing a Christmas song and keep on singing all season long. Think of the joy you'll bring if you just close your eyes and sing. And if you're short of cheer, think about that year. You woke up to find a brand new snow has fallen. The ornaments you made way back in second grade.
Untangling the Christmas lights took your father several nights.
Mother claimed that she had proof. There were reindeer on the roof. Remember who you were back then. Let those moments live again.
Let those moments live again.
Just
you did it, buddy.
Sing
you saved
a Christmas.
Hey, you
want to
ride back to the North Pole?
Keep
come
on,
on
singing.
I'm happy
all
right
season
here.
Season long.
Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night.
Christmas to all, and to all a good night, I proclaimed as I finished my rounds. Funny story, in all the excitement, I forgot the New Zealand this year. Completely slipped my mind. I popped back on the 26th and made good. Anyway, it wasn't long after that that Walter started his own publishing company, Hobbs & Sons. And Buddy Story went on to become the best-selling children's book in the world. And it probably won't come as a surprise to you that they all lived happily ever after. And that's it. That's the end of our story.
They're here.
Well, it's not quite the end. There's one last little chapter.
Merry Christmas, Santa!
Merry Christmas, Buddy!
Merry Christmas, everybody!
Merry Christmas, kids.
I'm singing! I'm at the North Pole and I'm singing! I've got a wife and I'm singing! And we did a special kind of hug that I'd never heard about before, and when it was over, I was singing! And now we've got a kid! So I'm singing! All I have to do is sing to stop a string of spooky songs. Cause nobody likes a Christmas song like little Buddy Hobbs. And that's why his middle name just happens to be Sparkle Jolly Twinkle Jingly.
You find that Buddy Junior takes after me. I'm Sparkle Jolly Twinkle Jingly.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
And when the baby's grown, he'll ride on my sleigh and they'll deliver.